What is limited connectivity and how do I fix it? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. If you're not signed up for Confident Computing, my weekly emailed newsletter, go visit askleo.com/newsletter today. Each week I share more answers, tips, tricks, and information about Windows, technology, and staying safe online. That's askleo.com/newsletter to sign up today. Let's dive right into this question. I've recently started receiving limited connectivity messages at our vacation condo. Looking on the web, I found a jillion ways to fix this problem, and I can't believe all the advertising. I found that cycling the repeater that is in our condo will usually clear this problem. What causes it, and what do I do when cycling the repeater doesn't work? Limited connectivity is one of those odd messages, because what it means is your computer has connected to the network, but it hasn't connected to the network. That's why it's confusing, because there's different kinds of connectivity. It's not very helpful, I get that, but it's also very accurate. More specifically, what it means is that your computer has connected to, I'll call it the physical network, be it an Ethernet cable or a wireless connection. And it knows that there's a connection. There's an actual connection that's been established at some kind of a layer, a hardware layer, like I said, is what I call it. It then has asked for some information. It normally will be asking for an IP address to be assigned to it. And that request went unanswered. It basically sent a message out on the connection and it never got a response. That could be due to a lot of different things, but let's back up and understand exactly what happens when you connect to a network for the first time. We'll start with an IP address. I think everybody understands that an IP address, Internet Protocol address, is the number that identifies your computer on its network. On a local network, when you're behind a router, the IP address is assigned by something called DHCP, Dynamic Host Configuration Protocol. What it boils down to is the computer shouts into the void, "Would someone please give me an IP address?" And when things are working properly, the void responds, right? A machine connected to that same local network is tasked with the responsibility of responding to that exact request. And it then responds with, "Hey there, here's an IP address for you." Now, in most cases, that machine tasked with that response is in fact your router. Your router handles handing out IP addresses to the machines that are connected to your local network. When it responds, it actually responds with more than just an IP address. It actually includes some additional information about exactly how your computer is supposed to not only identify itself, but also how it's supposed to reach out to the rest of the network beyond your router. Now, like I said, limited connectivity happens because you shout into the void, "Would somebody please give me an IP address?" And the void doesn't respond. There's no response. Now, what happens in a case like this is that most internet connections, most network connections, will attempt to make up an IP address. It's essentially, "You know what? If nobody's going to give me one, I'll just make one up." And if you've ever seen an IP address that begins with 169, chances are that is a made-up IP address. That, by definition, is the IP address that most network interfaces will assign to themselves. They'll make something up for themselves because they didn't get an IP address from a router or other DHCP server. Now, it may seem like, okay, great, you've got an IP address. Shouldn't it work? Remember, the DHCP server responded with two things. It responded not only with the IP address you're supposed to use, but also the additional instructions about how to connect to the rest of the network, how to connect to everything else. You didn't get that. In addition to not getting an IP address, you didn't get those instructions. And that means your computer doesn't know how to connect to the rest of the world. It's limited. That's why it says limited connectivity. Now, there are really obscure ways that even with a self-assigned IP address like that, if you really know what you're doing and you're super geeky, you can cause two computers to talk to one another using this limited connectivity. It's not easy. The whole point of DHCP is to just sort of make that all easy, make that all transparent, connect something up to the network, and stuff just starts to work. But in that case where you don't have an opportunity to get an IP address and the instructions for how to connect to the rest of the network, you're out of luck. There's just nothing you can do. No other computer will know how to contact you, and you will not know how to contact anything else on the internet or even on your own local network. So, how do you fix it? I wish I had an answer. I wish I had a consistent answer. I will say that what you've done, in your case, rebooting a repeater, in other cases, rebooting your router, generally solves the problem, I'll say 99% of the time. So that's the first thing you should do. If you're struggling with limited connectivity, then reboot your router and see what happens. Reboot your router, reboot your machine, and maybe it'll go away. Probably it'll go away. But it might not. If it doesn't, then essentially you need to double check all the pieces of networking between your computer and your router. Is the cable working, right? Did the cable break? There are ways that literally the cable itself can break so that the computer thinks it's connected to a network, but it still can't really communicate to anybody. Are there intermediary pieces of equipment like a switch or a hub or something else in between your computer and the router that does the assignment? Are those pieces all working? Is the wireless connection working the way you expect it to be? It's frustrating. It's a process of elimination. But those are the kinds of things you should be looking at first to see if you have a chance to fix limited connectivity. Like I said, sometimes routers just get confused. It happens and they need to be rebooted. Often it really is that simple. If it's not, start diagnosing the rest of the path between your computer and your router to at least get a start for a handle on the problem. For updates, for related links, for comments and more, visit askleo.com/14964. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is AskLeo.com. Thanks for watching.